So, welcome po natin ang ating resident preacher para sa ating pagbabahagi, si Brother Kicks.
Maraming salamat, Mang Gido, Kuya Motaman, si pa ba isa? Tatay Ace at si Sir Adrian, thank you for ano ba ang tawag ko dito? Priming up? Nung hinanda niyo ako para sa Gospel Reflection. Kaya basahin na po natin ang Gospel Reflection for today. Medyo mahaba-haba. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Since many have undertaken to compile a narrative of the events that have been fulfilled among us, just as those who were eyewitnesses from the beginning and ministers of the word have handed them down to us, I too have decided, after investigating everything accurately anew, to write it down in an orderly sequence for you, most excellent Theophilus, so that you may realize the certainty of the teachings you have received. Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit, and news of him spread throughout the whole region. He taught in their synagogues and was praised by all. He came to Nazareth, where he had grown up, and went, according to his custom, into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. He stood up to read and was handed a scroll of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord." Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intently at him. He said to them, "Today, this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." Sisters and brothers in Christ, mga kabahagi, the good news of our salvation. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. Medyo mahaba-haba po yung readings natin. Makikita po natin o mapapansin po natin, hinati po ang readings natin taken from chapter 1 of St. Luke, tapos tumalon po sa chapter 4. And here we can see that St. Luke, the gospel writer Luke, was not actually an eyewitness of Jesus. But he was what? He was a person who heard other people telling him the stories of the life of Jesus. And he decided to make a thorough investigation. Kinolekta niya ang mga data para magkaroon siya ng isang clear step-by-step introduction to the life of Jesus. Kaya sinulat niya ng mabuti ang Gospel of St. Luke. And remember that St. Luke is also a doctor, a physician. Kaya talagang marunong siya, may alam siya. At dito natin makikita at the end of the Gospel, sabi po ng ating Panginoon, tulad ng title po ng ating nakalagay sa YouTube today, "This scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." So ano po yung nangyari? Jesus, as was his custom on a Sabbath day, kasi yung po talaga ang tradisyon ng mga Hudyo, on a Sabbath, they worship God, they go and gather into the synagogue. Ang synagogue po ay para itong mga chapel sa mga iba't ibang bayan sa Israel. The main temple is in Jerusalem, which is of course the temple, yung pinaka-templo nila, di ba? But pag malayo ka sa temple at hindi ka makakapunta doon on a Sabbath, you go to the synagogue. And they read the scriptures para silang meron liturgical service. And in fact, according to scholars of the Bible, when Jesus took the scroll that was handed to him, it was the scroll of the prophet Isaiah, dahil po during the times, isa sa mga sikat na prophet si Isaiah, so they had a lot of copies of those scrolls distributed to different parts of Jerusalem or in synagogues. Anong binigay sa kanya yon, he found the passage in Isaiah chapter 60, tama ba ako, 60 or 61? 60 verse 1, na kung saan, during that time, wala pa pong mga Bible chapters and verses, ha? So puro sulat lang yon. He found that passage. In fact, according to scholars, iniiwasan ng mga Jewish people, basahin yung passage na yon. Because that passage pertains, points towards the Messiah, and for the Jewish tradition during that time, only the Messiah can read that portion of the scroll of the prophet Isaiah. Yung binasa natin ngayon, yung the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has anointed me to proclaim good tidings to the poor. Iniiwasan nilang basahin yun. Kasi nga po for them, yun Isaiah, yun Messiah lang, yun anointed one, yun pinili ng Diyos, ang may karapatan na basahin yun. Kaya minsan iniiwasan, they skip that. And that's why when Jesus was reading that, mapapansin natin that all in the synagogue, their eyes was upon Him. Parang kumbagay, ha? Bakit niya binabasa yun? Why? Because only the Messiah can read that. And sino nga si Jesus, di ba? This is what Luke was trying to portray in the gospel for today. Pinapakita po ni San Lucas na si Jesus ang Messias, the Christ na pinili ng ating Panginoon Diyos. And not only that, after reading that, sabi pa ni Jesus, today, this portion of the scripture has been fulfilled. Ibig sabihin siya yun.